Hello everybody, welcome back to another new and noteworthy mod review. Today we're going to take a look at automatic shipping of animal products. But before that, this video is brought to you by Mike Joel here and UTB. Thank you for being farm barons. So ever since Farm Sim 22 came out, people have been asking for the ability to distribute wool, eggs, and honey. As you know, with production in Farm Sim 22, you can set things to auto-distribute. Greenhouses you can set to distribute. Fabric you can set to distribute. All of the production, for the most part, you can set to distribute. And when you do that, it moves automatically down the production line to the next stage of operation. But for animal outputs, like honey for bees, eggs for chickens, and wool for sheep, we've still had to manually transport those. But that day is now over, because the automatic shipping of animal products mod is now available. You can find this mod over at the farmingsimulator.com website or the in-game downloadable content menu, and it is available for all platforms. So this is how it works. So we've got the animal area, base game animal area here for the sheep. This is where the wool typically would spawn. Well, we've placed this building down, which has a couple triggers. It has a trigger right here that overlaps the spawn point for the wool. And this building is now basically a little wool warehouse. It accepts wool as an input, and it will allow you to auto-distribute or auto-sell your wood. Your wool. Not your wood. Your wool. Same with the chickens. We have the same little building. It is designed for the chicken trigger, so eggs will spawn in here and immediately be ingested into the warehouse. The warehouse can be set to storing, distributing, or selling. And then, lastly, the same with the honey. Let's take a look at this stuff in the shop and talk about how you place it down. So, in the build mode, you're going to go to your animals. You're going to go sheep. And you have, of course, your traditional sheep buildings. Right? So we can put down the sheep pen right here. And then we have also the wool shipping mod for $500. And what we're going to do is we're going to overlap the wool shipping mod trigger with the pallet spawn trigger. And if we get the overlaps with another object, we're just going to hit V to enable free place mode. And we're going to plop it down. Just like that. Chickens. So we have the chicken coop. And then we have the egg shipping building. So we do the exact same thing as we did with the wool building. Just plop it down. If we get the overlap, then we just say V, ignore it, put it down. Bees. Now I can't put another one down because we already have one, but same thing. You put your trigger down. If you've got a mod that is multiple pallet trigger for bees, you can put those down. And then just place this down on top of it. And then you have the ability to do that. Now, as I have set this up, we've got chickens, we've got sheep, and I have some beehives over there. I'm going to set all of these to storing for now. So honey is set to store, and it will hold 5,000 liters in its little warehouse. I'm going to ship add wool to storing, and eggs are at storing. Storing. Change this one to storing the wool, eggs, and honey. Okay. And I am now going to fast forward one day. That way we now have some product. Now that we've progressed one game day, you see there is no wool in the wool spawn point. There are no eggs in the egg spawn point. And we do have some honey here over in the honey point. Now, if we go and look at our production, you're going to see we have 1,022 liters worth of honey. We have 647 liters worth of eggs. And we have 317 liters worth of wool. I'm going to fast forward a couple more days just so we get a bit more product in storage. You can see the little trigger here at the shed door. That is where pallets are going to spawn once they have collected enough into the warehouse. So we have our input trigger, our output trigger, our spawn point. We have eggs now here. And of course, we have our honey. Now, as we all know, with production, if I come over here now and I move this to distributing, I move my eggs to distributing and my honey to distributing. And then let's fast forward an hour. What we're going to see is we're going to see that product move from the warehouse over to our production facilities. So it is a new hour. Let's take a look. We now only have 130 liters of honey. We have 253 liters of wool or eggs and 91 liters of wool. We come over to our production. You can see we now have 1,135 liters of wool. We have 3,800 liters of honey already moved over here. And we have 444 liters worth of eggs already moved over to our production. Didn't have to do anything. And of course, if we want to, we could move our pallet of eggs, our pallet of wool, and our pallet of honey that spawned in the one pallet spawn point over to those areas. And now that we have it set to distributing, we'll never see pallets spawn at the output point. Or, as I said at the intro, if you weren't overly concerned about cereal production and you just wanted to have bees and make money off of honey, then set it to auto sell and then you're done. It just sells. You'll get money every hour for the honey that is generated by your beehives. So guys, that is the automatic shipping of animal products mod. Let me know down in the description below if you're going to be adding this mod to your mod folder and putting it down on your honey spawn point, your chicken areas. You'll need one warehouse, of course, for each chicken coop if you have multiple chicken coops, or your sheep areas. And until next time, happy farming.